Hey guys, it's Miss Canaday again. So good to see you. We are going to be jumping into another writing prompt. Today, our writing prompt is called Living in a Colony of Rock Hyraxes. So this animal is indigenous to the mountain ranges of Africa. All right, let's go ahead and get into it. High atop Mount Kenya, there lived a colony of rock hyraxes in a rocky outcropping. The outcropping they chose must have cracks or crevices that are too small for larger animals. It must face the morning sun and be surrounded by a meadow to graze in. This colony has found the perfect place. They have a bathroom nearby that they all use. The colony is led by a single older male, four females, and their young. At night, they sleep huddled together or even stacked high on top of one another for warmth. In the morning, they come out onto the rocks and stay huddled until the sun warms them. Once warmed, they make their way down a path to the grassy area surrounding their home. The male sits on a rock overlooking the area and keeps watch. If the male or a bird sounds an alarm, everyone will scurry for the rocks. The colony eats quickly and ambles back to their outcropping. There, they sit in the sun and nap until the afternoon, when they'll make another trip down to the meadow. This morning was like most others. Everyone fanned out to eat down at the meadow. A bird close by sounded an alarm. The male let out a loud squeak with his mouth open and his lips drawn back. Everyone ran for cover in the outcropping. One of the young hyraxes was confused and did not make it back to the rocks. A leopard pounced on him. The leopard tossed it about for a while and then took it to her cub, who played with it, pouncing on it and tossing it. The hyrax showed no signs of life. Then the cub left it on a ledge and walked towards its mother. The hyrax jumped up and ran for a crevice and disappeared. The leopard caught the sudden movement and tried to follow it, but the tricky little hyrax was nowhere to be seen. Inside of the crack, the hyrax could see the nose of the cub sniffing for him. The cub tried to get his paw inside, and the hyrax backed up deeper into the little cave. Finally, the cub lost interest and left. It started to get dark. The young hyrax was so cold without his family to keep him warm. He huddled back into the cave and tried to sleep. As the first rays of sunshine hit the rock outside, he peeked out to see if the leopards were nearby. He heard a cheerful chirping of the birds, and he felt safe. He climbed out into the rocks and warmed himself in the sun. Now, all he had to do was find his way home. He saw some rocks across the meadow. He ran for the rocks, but nothing smelled familiar. He climbed up on the highest point and looked around. Over there, he saw a rock outcropping covered in furry mounds. He gave a little yelp, and the mounds yelped back. He ran as fast as he could, which is not very fast. He crossed the meadow, and he ran up the slope, and he could smell home. He was greeted by his mother and his brother, and everyone came to see that he still lived. He was the hyrax that survived the leopards. All right, guys. So I want you to imagine maybe you're one of the animals in this story. Maybe you're that young hyrax, or maybe you're the mother of that young hyrax. Or perhaps you're a leopard. Maybe you're the leopard cub, or even you could be the bird that set off the alarm to let them know that a predator was close. It's completely up to you. I want you to use your imagination and complete this writing prompt. All right, guys, I cannot wait to see your writings. I know you're going to do wonderfully. All right, until next time.